I, Anjali Bansal, Assistant Professor, Punjab University, is giving presentation on the topic Separation of Powers. The term Separation of Powers was coined by a French jurist, Montesquieu, in his book El Spirit des Lois, meaning thereby Spirit of Laws, published in 1748. The doctrine of Separation of Powers deals with the mutual relations among the three organs of the government, namely legislature, executive, and judicial. According to Montesquieu, there can be no liberty if the legislative and executive powers are amalgamated in the same person or body, or judicial power is not separated from the legislative and executive power. The integration of judicial and legislative power would expose the life and liberty of the subject to arbitrary control, as judge would then be the legislator. Judges might behave with violence and oppression if judiciary is merged with the executive. The position of this doctrine has to be studied vis-a-vis United Kingdom, United States of America, and India. Doctrine of Separation of Powers in UK. There are three different organs operating in England, that is, Parliament, King, and the courts. Parliament is having lawmaking powers, King is the executive head, and courts are having judicial powers. The definition given by Wade and Phillips relating to separation of power is having three features. First, the same person should not form more than part of one organ. One organ of the government should not exercise the function of the other organs of the government. And thirdly, one organ of the government should not encroach with the function of the other two organs of the government. Applicability of this doctrine in England. The king, being the executive head, is also an integral part of the legislature. His ministers are also members of one or other houses of parliament. This concept goes against the idea that same person should not form part of more than one organ of the government. The House of Commons control the executive. So far as judiciary is concerned, in theory, House of Lords is the highest court of the country, but in practice, judicial functions are discharged by specially appointed lords and other lords who held judicial post. Thus, we can say that doctrine of separation of powers is not applicable to Britain in strict sense. Now, doctrine of separation of powers in USA. In USA, there are three different organs operating, that is, Congress, second, President, and third, Supreme Court. The legislative branch is ruled by the Congress, who makes the law. The executive branch, in executive branch, the President enforces the law, and in judicial branch, Supreme Court interprets the law. The definition given by Madison relating to separation of power is the accumulation of all powers, legislative, executive, and judicial, in the same hands, whether of one, a few, or many, and whether hereditary, self-appointed, or elective, may justly be pronounced the very definition of tyranny. System of checks and balance in USA. The President of the United States interferes with the exercise of powers by the Congress through the exercise of his veto power. He also exercises the law-making power in exercise of his treaty-making power. He also interferes with the functioning of the Supreme Court through the exercise of his power to appoint judges. In the same manner, Congress interferes with the power of the President through vote on budget, approval of appointments by the Senate, and the ratification of treaty. It also interferes with the exercise of powers by the courts by passing procedural laws, creating special courts, and by approving the appointment of judges. In its turn, judiciary interferes with the powers of the Congress and the President through the exercise of the power of the judicial review.